Hey, it's Andrew Laurie. Gonna go over our P&L for March here for Pretzel Factory of Avondale. Sorry, it's been a couple weeks. We actually started a new marketing person. She's behind the camera, Jasmine. We'll introduce her a little bit more later. But I did want to get into what I promised you guys, and that is getting into the profit and loss and where we've seen some gains and what we need to work on. Actually, last month we hit the numbers pretty spot on, so there's really nothing too much to work on. I would call it almost a perfect month. We would have liked 10% growth, but we got 3% growth. But again, that comes with a lot of territory, and kind of that's what I'll go into. So, just to go over the numbers. Last month we did $34,921.09 in sales. Royalties, we pay 6%, so $2,095.28. Labor costs, $6,128.18, which came down to 17.5%. Now, the reason it's so low was we had 3 snow days. So 3 days we were not in the store at all because we had to be closed, which also results in why we were only 3% up. Those 3 days were Wednesdays. Typical Wednesday, we do anywhere between $900 to $1,100. You get those back, we're actually at 10%. So I'm very proud of us for that month. Cost of goods, $7,494.9 down to 21%. Now these two numbers, labor costs should be anywhere between 22 to 25% for a pretzel factory, with myself actually not working in the store. I did work in the store a couple hours, so that also helped bring that down. Cost of goods, I try to keep it under 25%. Cost of goods is our Dietz and Watson, which is all our meats. It is our Coke products, actually Coke products for both stores, as well as our large orders, so our flour and all that stuff from our provider there. So 21%, we gained 4% there. Very happy with that. Our lease, $3,538.65. Now we've been there for 10 years and this is a great lease. Honestly, we love our landlords over in Avondale and they do a great job with us. We work together. We are one of the top producing stores there, so we bring in a lot of customers, so that's why we do have that lease. Utilities, $1,000. Again, that's probably a little bit high. We don't run heat because we have a 500 degree oven, so we really don't need to run heat. So even in the cold month, we still run about that 925 to 1,000 range. So I put down 1,000 just so I have my numbers, because I won't get that bill for another couple weeks. Vehicle costs. So we have a delivery vehicle that we use and it's $375 a month. Our insurance, which is our liabilities, our umbrella policies, $420 a month. Marketing, $1,000. Again, I kind of use a round number here because it's cash and accrual basis what I do. The reason it's $1,000 is we do Clipper magazine, and then obviously we have a marketing person, which is their salary. And then number two, it's all the Facebook and social media promotions and all that stuff, which we're actually gonna dive even harder into. So this number I expect to go up next month. National advertising, we pay 2% into that, so it's $698.42. What that is it's for the brand to use to build up the brand within our market in the nation. Miscellaneous costs, $498.28. Actually, that's really low. Typically, we run about 5 to 10% on miscellaneous costs. That's those like things like hand wash soap and all those things that you have to run next door to Acme and grab. So, last month we put $8,697.02 to the bottom line, which equals 25%. Typically, we run about 23%, so we gained 2% there. I'm very, very happy about this. We're showing some nice consistent growth and consistent scheduling, so that helps with our variable cost, which is our labor. Obviously, cost of goods is a variable cost as well, and everything else is pretty much fixed. Royalties, obviously, is based on revenue. So that's our P&L for Pretzel Factory of Avondale. What do I see when I run? Look at these numbers. I look at these. These tell a story, and what the story is telling me is with closing down for 3 days, we kept our labor really low. With cost of goods and our new ordering manager, he's doing a great job keeping it at 21%. We actually have a little bit extra because of those 3 days, and that's gonna roll into this month. But, you know, the numbers are in line. As long as we can keep steady with these numbers and keeping the percentages, you know, maybe bring this up to 21%, keeping this at 22 to 23%, and then this rising by our 10%, you know, April's one of our larger months, so, you know, we should do about $40,000, so then the numbers keep coming down. So, very happy with our month, very happy with what happened at Pretzel Factory of Avondale. Why am I showing you this? I'm showing you that you can make money in a business like pretzels, honestly. And you gotta know your numbers, you have to know your numbers. Especially as a franchisee, when you're paying your royalties, you're paying your brand fund, you gotta know your numbers. Your numbers tell you the story. What this number to this number is showing me is that actually the amount that we're buying in flour and everything is actually getting sold as well. We're not having a lot of waste. We're not, you know, having a lot of theft, and that's a great thing. But all those story, like, all those numbers tell a story. So the story next week is I'm actually going to show you Chad's Ford. And I'm going to show you Chad's Ford from February, which is our February or March, maybe both. And what you're going to see there is actually theft, a lot of theft that we finally caught. You know, the story kept writing and writing and writing, but you need proof, and it showed finally. It's not a great thing, but it can happen. But we're going to show you how we came about finding actually what happened and what was going on. So that's kind of the story on Pretzel Factory of Avondale for March. I'll go over the story for Pretzel Factory of Chad's Ford. And then I'm going to start working on getting a franchisor to sit down with me for the third video. We're going to go sit down with the franchisor. Why did they become a franchise system? It'll be a longer video, and we'll go from there. But please, check out all our Instagrams, our Facebook pages for Pretzel Factory of Avondale, PPF Avondale, Pretzel Factory of Chad's Ford, PPF Chad's Ford, College Hunks of Kennett on Instagram, College Hunks of Kennett Square for Facebook, and then obviously my personal business Instagram is Andrew J. Laurie. You know, get some content. I would highly advise, you know, this story, this is going to go out tomorrow, but I think I'm going to keep my rant that's going to go on there. It might be five stories. It's going to be a long one. But there's going to be a rant going on my Instagram stories that I'm going to save for a while on employment and actually having a care about what you do, no matter what it is. And I think that's what really separates anybody that starts their own business from just kind of an employee that decides, hey, I'm out, I quit. You know, an entrepreneur is gonna go through those hard times and try to find the positive and work towards the positive, where if it's an employee and they just feel, I'm done, I'm out, I'm out. So we're gonna go over that on Instagram. But again, thanks for catching into the video. We'll see you next week.